Welcome to all of you to a new lecture on the construction management. As for the SLUET new syllabus, we can cover all the topics, all the chapters contained in our video lecture. And all the video lectures will be available in our Jharsuguda Engineering School website. So myself, Niranjan Jana, from the Department of Civil Engineering, Jharsuguda Engineering School, Jharsuguda. So first we discuss here the construction management. So now check. This is your content. So today I'll deliver this content: introduction, objectives of construction management, functions of construction management, and components of construction management. So all of the topics will be discussed by today. So first word is construction management. We all know construction means that is an ongoing activities. Management, in the management we cover there are different types of management, means time management, cost management, our labor or manpower management, and material management. So in this construction management, the time can be managed. There is a different bar chart method, CPM, POT. On this topic we cover what are the methods to control the time. And to the cost management, on the construction management there is a chapter, crossing of network. How can we cross our network or reduce our time to manage the cost? And next is manpower and labor management. That can be managed by the construction manager. So we have some ability to manage the time, cost, money, and the materials. So here it is written, construction management is an art of planning, coordinating, controlling various construction activities. In this construction management, we deal with our planning, coordinating, and controlling. Planning, coordinating, and controlling of various construction activities. So first, what is the meaning of planning? Planning means what to do and how to do. What the thing will be done at the site, it will be pre-planned. And in scheduling, that means when to do it. In planning we have covered what to do it and how to do it. But in scheduling, we detail discuss when to deem it at the time scale. We discuss the time scale. So now there is some objectives of construction management. So first point, completing the work in the estimated budget and specific time. Our first aim, we complete the project with an estimated budget, with estimated money, and with a specified time. Suppose you have fixed the 6 month time period for a project. So you are with a time bounded and the money budget bounded. So you have to complete your project within that money and that time period. Then second point, evolving high quality of workmanship. It does not only we deal with the time and the cost. We should prepare a good quality and good structure, good workmanship, good quality control. Then third, providing safe working conditions for all. That is, safety is an important measure for every construction on the field. It is a challenge. In our current situation, safety is a challenge. So we should deal with the zero hazards, zero accident zone. That means the labor, our staffs, all the members in the organization should be safe. Next is taking sound decision at lowest practical management level through the delegation of authority. Your decision should be sound, should be good decision. We should take the sound decision at our level, at our end. Next, motivating people to give their best within their capacity. We should always motivate our colleagues, motivate our team members to do their best. Because if from one we try to do the best, our organization will develop. We should compete with our intervener. In the market, only our company is not only one company, there is a variety of companies. So we should practice our best efforts. We should give our best efforts. Next, creating and organizing that works as a team. Always, on the construction side, as a construction manager, your duty is to work as a team member, you work as a family member. The all people on the organization is your family.
family.
So next there is some functions of construction management. First one is planning and scheduling, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling and coordinating. So first we deal with the planning and scheduling. Planning and scheduling. Planning means what to do and how to do. Scheduling means when to do it. At the time fix. You should fix the time when that activity, that event will be done at the site. Next is organizing. So you should prepare a better organization, a teamwork. Next, staffing. Staffing means staff requirement. Suppose you are working on an organization, there is insufficient staff to progress the work, to progress, continue the construction activity. So you should require the engineer, you should require the labor, you should require the manpower at your end. Next is directing. Directing means you direct your staff. You direct from the head of the organization. If your order is passed, then the people who is belong to that organization should obey that law and order, should obey that order. So you should direct. At the construction field, the manager should direct the employees what to be done at the site. Next is controlling. Only directing, if you direct your work is over, that your work is not over, you should control. If something is not going as per your plan, suppose you plan to excavate or PCC or brickwork, number of days. Suppose the work is not as per the actual, then you should control. Control means you should take some 2 hours OT overtime period, then the work should be done at the time. Next is coordinating. Coordinating with all your team members, coordinating with the people. The people may be a labor, may be the engineer, may be the architecture. Your main aim to coordinate the ground levels. So here is the detail notes. Planning. The main planning is what to do and how to do, already I have discussed. In the planning involves formulation of number of alternative realistic plan. So plan maybe you should think something, but that should be realistic. You should execute that plan in your field. That should not be imaginary plan. If you imagine, then that plan will not be work on the site. That should be a realistic plan. In scheduling, that means scheduling is the fitting of final work plan to a time scale. Within time scale, within time period, you fix your work. Suppose you fix on the first day, you should clear the site. Next, excavation. Next, sand filling. Brickwork, PCC, so the work will be goes on. Next, organizing means division of construction into the manageable departments. One member, one head of the department cannot control the all works going on the organization. He or she should direct or organize the people on the ground level. That means you divide the work. Next, systematic arranging various operations. Your operations at the site should be systematically managed. The realistic between various personnel are established. You should establish the good relation with all employees at your organization. Not only the construction field, at every organization, you should establish a good relationship with your colleagues or with your member. Next is staffing means, already I have discussed, staff function includes recruiting of the right people, arranging the staff, carrying out the proper staff assessment. Means you should recruit the staff and train them 1 month or 2 months training. Then after the training you can assign at the field. They are capable to work at the site. Directing is the function concerned with the training subordinates to carry out assistance work. You should direct your assistant to carry out that work. If you want to take the screenshot, you can take the screenshot from the previous slide. Here is the first slide. Next, our functions, main objectives of the construction management. You can take the screenshot. Next, the functions of construction management, planning, organization, scheduling. Take the screenshot. Next, controlling and coordinates. Controlling is necessary for ensuring effective and efficient work. Your work is efficient or effective, you should check it. Always directing is the best solution, that is not the best solution. You should control each activity, each work going on the site. It involves a constant review of the work plan to check the actual achievements. Suppose you plan something, you should always check your plan activity with your actual ongoing works. So that is the process of controlling. You should control what is the plan and what is the going on at the site. You should compare your plan and the actual. In the coordinating, it is necessary to bring together and coordinate the work. At an organization, you should coordinate with each and every member. You should coordinate with your team. Then regular meetings of the department held in the top management. Only one in 1 week or at the end of the month, you should arrange a department meetings. You should take the review of the construction work. What should be completed and what will be done at the next week. You should prepare a plan. You should coordinate with your staff members to arrange a department meetings. Next, plan, problems and control technique or solutions are discussed for determining the best solution. If one member will take the decision, that decision may not be a good, may not be the best. So always coordinate with your team. Take some decisions from your team members. Then analyze which was the best solution. If you think I am the construction manager, I will take the decision. No, you should coordinate with your members. What are their views? You take their views and decision. Then analyze which one is the best solution, then you can implement that in the field. So next we discuss in a construction team. These are the team members in construction team. Owner, engineer, architect and contractor. First, owner. Owner may be a government body or may be a private body. You can see here. Owner, the person in charge of overall project usually termed as owner, and it is often the only non-professional in the entire project. Maybe the owner is a professional. Suppose the PWD, NHI, suppose the government of Odisha, central government that is carrying out the work. Suppose government of Odisha is the owner. So that is a government owner. But the owner may be individual, may be a person. Suppose I am going to prepare a building. I have no idea about the building, about the construction management, about the any material. So I will purchase a contractor. I will contract with some team member or company. So that is the owner. So owner may be a private or may be a government. If a government body, that may be central government or state government. Private means as an individual, as a company. What are the functions of owner? Providing financial for the project. If I am going to prepare a building, then definitely I will pay for it. I will provide the budget, I will provide the money, financial money. Then interpreting the documents. You should interpret with all the documents. Then securing or paying for the easements. Warranting the plans and specifications. Acting on clarification and changes. Suppose you want some clarification, suppose government wants some clarification. So can discuss with the engineer or can discuss with the contractor. So mainly the owner is a government body or private body. Next go to the engineer. Engineer and there is the architecture. So first discuss the engineer. Engineer is a trained person. He or she has some technical knowledge. How to prepare the plan, how to prepare the bar building, how to prepare the scheduling, detailing, networking, all the ideas. So as an engineer or an architecture, you should prepare the drawing, detailing, bar building schedule, your estimate cost, everything should be prepared. And here you can take the screenshot of an architecture and what are the functions. Assisting the client to prepare a strategic brief. Carrying out the feasibility studies and the optional appraisal. Preparing the concept design. Your main aim as an engineer, your main aim is to design and detailing. You should give the design and detailing to the client. And next is contractor. A contractor is any individual or organization that is hired to perform the work. Means contractor hire the some person to perform that work. managing the project, monitoring the project, legal regularity and responsibility, health and success, and safety responsibility. At the site, the contractor should give the priority to the health and the safety of the laborers, all the people employed at that organization, that team. So mainly there is, if you discuss, mainly there is three parts. Owner, engineer or architecture, and another one is contractor. So you can check here. Here is the relationship. We may conclude here in our last slides. Here is the interrelationships. What are the relationships between owner, engineer and contractor? It is clearly visible. The solid line means there is some contractual bond. In this figure, there is some solid line. You can check here. In this side, there is some solid line. That means some contractual bond. And here is the bond is dotted lines. That means a non-contractual bond. So what is the contractual bond? That means the bond is prepared with the agreement between the engineer, between the owner. Again, the owner and contractor. But there is no agreement, no bond between the engineer and contractor. It's a non-contractual bond. So you can check the first process. So first, already I discussed. The owner means it's a government or private. So if owner is a government or private, so first owner hire the engineer, hire himself and fees. Owner hire the engineers and pays the fee. Pele, the owner will hire the engineer. And that fee will be payment by the owner if he is a government organization. Suppose the engineer is an assistant executive engineer or junior engineer, the payment is done from the state government. If the owner is a private party, then he or she can pay to the engineer directly. Then engineer submits the project documents. The engineer will submit the project document to the government. Next, contractor and owner. There is a contractual relationship. Always with the contractor and the engineer, contractor and owner, there is a contractual relationship. So first government will provide the tender notice on the official website or newspaper or in the notice board. So the all interested contractors will apply that contract. Contract means it's a bond between the government and that person. Then when the contract applied, then selected by the government, then the government should give the work to the contractor. Then government assigns, this is the documents, take the documents and prepare the work or complete the work. First, government requires the engineer and assign the work to prepare the drawing, detailing, plan, bargaining schedule. Then after the completion of this documents, then engineer submit it to the government. Then government immediately issue a tender notice. Then the number of contractors are interested to apply that notice. Then when a contractor get the work order, get the that job, then the government will hand over all the documents to that contractor. Then the contractor complete the work and handed over the completion project. After the complete of the building, after complete of the bridge, after the complete of the road, after the complete of the each project, then the contractor should hand it over to it the government. After the complete, that building will be utilized by the government or utilized for the public. Suppose there is a road, after the completion, that road will be used by the public. So first, engineer prepared the detailing, drawing, scheduling, handed over to the government. Then government assigns to a contractor. Then contractor prepared that road or bridge, then handed to the government. Then that project is open to the public. Public can use that project, use that building, use that road. So this is the relationship, interrelationship between the team members. Engineer, owner and contractor, they are working as a team. So now take the screenshot. So thank you all of you for your patience. If you have any queries, you can contact me through this WhatsApp number or this email ID. If you submit any query, then from my side, I will try to solve your issue as soon as possible. Also, you can comment in the comment box. If you have any queries, you can comment in the comment box. And like and subscribe and share with your friends, so definitely you will get the benefits from this lecture. The whole lectures will be uploaded in this website. and it will be as per your SETVT syllabus. Thank you, all of you.